Hello, my name is Sean Martinson. I'm the superintendent of ISD 318 Grand Rapids Big Fork. I've been asked to come and say a few words. As you can imagine, there's really no script, and I don't know what I'm going to say other than as I sit down, Governor Walz has just spoken and given us a little bit more clarification as far as what's going on with our school system. Specifically related to our school system, the governor announced today that although there is a stay-at-home effective through April 10th, distance learning for our K-12 students will start Monday the 30th and run through at least April 30th, and I'll give you a little bit more information from my end as far as what I'm hearing. So now distance learning, although it could be many different things, we're trying to really stress that what we're seeing for our secondary learners, so although there might be a little bit of gray area there, for our 9th through 12th graders, there will be some expectations of work being done online. And everything that I'm about to talk about, you know, if a family needs help, I can't help but encourage you enough to go to our school district website, which is www.isd318.org. There's more information on that website in relation to our COVID-19 response, and I'll talk about that. I hope you don't mind that I'm kind of snowballing here as I'm taking a lot into. As a school district staff, we have been told to prepare to teach kids at a distance, which kind of the Reader's Digest version is this: to provide what we do in a school with kids, but to provide that to kids when they're not there. And as you can probably imagine, that's a pretty daunting task. So starting this coming Monday the 30th, schools are pushing out low-tech and no-tech options, but also some options that do require technology. What we were shared with from the governor today was that we should plan on this running through at least the 30th, but there were a couple of other dates that they shared. And again, everything could change at a moment's notice. This is just what I know as of today. Our teachers will expect to return on site May 1st and May 4th to prepare for the return of students on May 5th. So again, this is what we know as of today, that staff should plan to be back on May 1st and May 4th and prepare to have students back on site May 5th. That could very well change though. As a school system, we've been asked to do three primary functions during this crisis. And I'm going to rank order them in at least Sean's rank ordering. The first is to provide emergency child care for emergency responders. The second is to provide food for our families, whether that be at pickup sites, which would be at all of our physical school locations in the entryway from 11 to 11:30 on Monday through Fridays, but then also a delivery option for those that can't make it in. And the third is to provide distance learning and services, and I don't want to undersell it, I guess, but from a distance, meaning try to provide and make that connection to families in their homes even though they're not at school. So how do we do all of this? Well, with a lot of help from our friends. I think that was Joel Cocker had a good song. How do we get by this? We get by with a lot of help from our friends. This has taken an immense amount of teamwork. As you may have heard in the governor's original statement, that school district staff and personnel will continue to work, and we will continue to work even through the shelter at home, an essential task being staff being able to go to and from the job and the work site. If you're an emergency responder or a medical professional, the tier one for child care, there's a list on our district website and a spot to sign up. But I'd like to talk a little bit more, I guess, about how we provide the food. That if you're struggling to find food, I try not to get choked up, but it happens. On our district website, isd318.org, there is a spot to sign up for food to be delivered or picked up. And again, the pickup is at any one of our school sites in the entryways, Monday through Friday. ISD318.org, and click on the COVID-19 response list link at the top, and you'll be brought to a separate website. These are trying times for everybody. And I'm not making light of any situation, and I know we try to use humor sometimes to alleviate stress, but I can't find myself even doing that. I can't understand and can't even begin to comprehend the stress that this has caused for our families. We talk about it as an institution in the state about providing equity to education for all, and I can share with you how we try to provide that for all students as they come to our facilities. We can't control the home environment of families, and nor are we trying to. Don't hear me say that. But for kids to be off-site, this is a trying time for a lot of families. So when I make the statement of you know, reach out to your neighbor within social distancing guidelines, but to reach out to your neighbors and offer a helping hand when you can. You know, how are we going to get through this? With a lot of help from our friends and our neighbors. To be checking on those that maybe you haven't heard from in a while, or to check on those that are elderly that you know can't get out. Even with Governor Walz's order to shelter at home, we're still allowed to travel out and get groceries. And you might find a time where people around you need help getting those groceries. You know, as a school district leader and not really having a script to follow for any of this process, or really to know what lies ahead, all of us will do the best we can with what we know today. And I would encourage everybody to do the best you can, where you can, when you can. That may take many forms. It may simply be picking up the phone and making a phone call. It might be sending a letter. It might be, you know, checking with your neighbor to find out what groceries they need and picking up something for them and dropping it off at their door. I can't help but stress enough what Governor Walz had shared today, that, you know, the only way we can slow the spread of the coronavirus or COVID-19 is the social distancing. And I've heard different perspectives on what that means. I am of the group that believes the science, that we need to make decisions based on scientific research and knowledge, and that there is a reason to adhere to social distancing as best you can to slow this down, help our medical professionals be better prepared and continue to build capacity. Man, I could talk forever. It really boils down to, though, there's no script to follow. Everybody's doing the best that they can every day, and if they're not, they should be. Do the best you can, help where you can, when you can, and however you can, and every day is a new day.